So in this video, I'm going to talk about power analyzer of Hioki. The model number is 3390, that's PW3390 exactly. So on the last video, I talked about power quality analyzer, and it's close to related to the same series or topic, you can say. And today I'll show you how to operate this power analyzer, what are the features in it, which key do what, and how to save the data, and how to retrieve the data, how to use the software. So I'll try to make this video as simple as possible so that you guys can able to understand much clearly by this video only. So let's start the video. So first I'll explain you what all the things are there in this power analyzer, and how to operate and all those things. So from this side there is nothing, only the exit vent is there. Then on the other side, I'll come close to the camera. Yeah, so this one is lamp. These are to the sink in and sink out, USB and RS232. So sink in and sink out is to when you have a multiple power analyzers, so these two are being used to sync to each other. And on the back side, these are the power in, ground connection, channels for voltage and current, four channels. These are for the motor inputs, and this is for the DAO, digital to analog output. So now on the front side, as you can see, so this, the handle over there can be rotated like this. Okay, so you just need to press these two buttons, and then this top handle will come to the down, and then it will make the inclined position of this instrument so that it will be very easy to operate it when you are using this instrument in any kind of lab or in this kind of desk situation. So it became easy to see the display. Okay, so now on the front screen, as we have seen on the power quality analyzer, so the top keys are the main keys to toggle onto the main pages. Then the page scroller keys are these two. So when we are onto any kind of particular setting, we can change the page by these two keys. The below keys are for the navigation up and down, left and right, and to select. These are switch on key, and then these are the manual keys for the low pass filter, and these are for the frequency, for the hold, save function, zero adjust, data reset, and this is for the recording start and stop. Okay, now I will connect it to the power, and let's switch on the instrument. So this power analyzer needs a single phase in as a normal power cord. There is no adapter for it, and I will switch it on. Now initially it will start up, and it will reboot few of the things here to check whether everything inside the hardware software is fine, and it will come to this home screen, which is related to the settings and all. Now I will explain you the features and how to set the instrument before performing any kind of test. So on the home screen, the first thing is a channel setting. So all the channels are independent, as I told you. So in this you can make the configuration like this. So the first three channel I have configured as three phase four wire, and the fourth channel is independent. So I can make a configuration like this, any kind of configuration, or all the four channel can be independent. So while you are doing this kind of settings or the connection, the basic parameters will come down, the voltage, current and the power. Then on the next page is the settings which we need to do. The settings are like First is the sink source. We need to define which is the sink source, and then the voltage range. So this one can start from zero and can go up to 1500 volt. We need to press F1 and F2 like this. So now it became 30, 60, 50, 600 and 1500 volt. Like that, the voltages can be defined and we can put it to auto range as well. Right, and then we can define whether we are doing the RMS testing or the mean testing. Then we can define the VT ratio, the current range also we can define or put it to auto, and then we can define the whether it's a RMS or a mean. Then again we can define the CT ratio, the low pass filter we can define. On the previous video I have explained what is low pass filter, and the integration mode also we can define, and the frequency measurement, whether you want to do the frequency measurement for voltage or current, it can be defined by pressing F1 or F2, right? And then if I come to the other side, as this instrument can work from DC to 200 kilohertz, we can define the operating frequency range. From here we can define the same. So this you can define by pressing F1, F2, F3 up to F6. You can define what is the locus frequency on which you are working, right? And then harmonic sync you can define, and then what type of THD calculations you want to do, what is the motor sync timing and all. So all those things can be defined on this page. Now the next page is for the calculation. So as this instrument is a power analyzer and all the channels are independent, so here we can do the efficiency calculation in between any phase to phase, or we can make the initial three channels as a three phase four wire and the fourth channel as an independent, and then we can do the efficiency calculations. So all those calculation can be put here. And then the noise sampling points we can define, the lowest noise frequency we can define, and the total points we can define. Then after that, if we are doing the noise analysis, then we can define the window type, and if we want to do the averaging or the zero filter, these things can be defined here. After that, the interval we can define. The interval starts from 50 milliseconds, and then there are several settings. The maximum one is the 60 minutes. If you want to do the timing recording or the stop recording, then we can define the particular date and time. According to that, it will start recording and then stop recording. Then this is related to the data saving and the sync. So here we can define this instrument is a master or slave if there is a multiple instruments. So you can define whether this instrument is a master or a slave. Then the sync source we can define, the saving we can define here. Like this, where I want to save the data, whether on a USB pen drive or a CF card. The CF card comes here and the pen types comes here. Then auto save should be on and off, means like when I press the start, then it will start saving the recording, or if I want to do the manual, then I need to press this key. Then the folder I can define, the save folder name can be defined here. And similarly, this is an important thing. So if I go inside this setting, so I can define what type of parameter I want to lock. So this is for voltage. So like this, we can select or unselect, like that we can do. Similarly, we can return back and then like current we can define, return for power we can define here, and the integration we can define here. Even we can do the current positive integration, negative integration, and energy as well. So this IH values are basically what I've seen being used for the EV or the hybrid vehicles. They were where they want to see the charging and discharging of a battery. Like that, you can define for harmonics and for other parameters related to the temperature, the channel ABC, like for the motor. I told you that motor input is also there. That can also be defined here. Then the interval we can define, at what interval we want to save. And this is for the interface, whether we want to do the LAN, RS-232 or the IP configurations can be done here. Then the we can define the language, the LCD color, like there are four color schemes here. You want to have the beep sound or not can be defined here. The date time can be set here, and all those things. The system reset also can be done here. So these things can be set here. After that, there is a motor sync function. So as we can similarly with the power analysis, we can do the motor analysis test as well in this 3390. So first we need to sync the instrument, and after that we means like if the motor is having a transducer which is having a voltage output in the form of means like voltage output for the RPM, torque and the Z phase, then we can feed in these voltages output from our transducer to the our power analyzer, and then we can compare the motor efficiency. In this we are actually comparing the efficiency between the mechanical and the electrical input and output of the motor, and then by the help of this power analyzer we can test a whole system which is having a electrical as an input and the output as in the form of mechanical for a motor kind of testing. This can be tested by this 3390. So these settings need to be done regarding related to the transducer output and all. We need to define the voltage and the motor related parameters here, the poles and all, the rotation RPM and all, we need to define it here, and then it will start calculating the efficiency of the system. And then later on, this is for the D output setting. So as I told you, this instrument is having a D output. If you want to feed in the parameters to a secondary data logger, then we can take out the parameters in the form of analog signal, and then we can feed into a data logger, and then we can log the parameters and so. Now I'll come to the measurement screen. Now in this measurement screen you will see all the type of the parameters and the waveform and the noise calculation, harmonics and all those things, and the vector we can see on this measurement screen. First we need to press this key, and again then the page toggle key. Now the first screen here is related to the channel 1 parameters. So in this one, in the channel 1 parameters, you can first see the phase wise parameters, and the particular parameters can be seen here. So if I press the F1 key for the power parameters, it will come up here, and from the navigation keys we can select the these particular things. Okay, now after that, integration, voltage, current, harmonic graph and the harmonic list can be seen here. Similarly, if I press again the page key, then it will toggle to the next phase and so on, and the rest of the things will be same. So basic things will also be coming here as well, like frequency and all, and what ranges we have selected. right now it comes to the phase 3, channel 4. Now this is for the waveform and noise. So here you can see the voltage and current waveforms. Here we can see the phase wise voltage and current waveform. Here we can see the noise, the waveform plus noise. So it's a kind of you can say the FFT analysis or something we can do. And this is for the save key. So if you want to save the particular the noise data, that it can be saved from this by pressing this key. So there is a separate saving function for noise calculation. Now if I come to the next page, these are particular selection page. If I want to go to the zoom, then it can be done like that. If I press this F6, if I press this F6, I can select the particular parameter I want to see, like this. All those parameters can be selected here, and then if I select anything like this, then it will be selected. Okay, so all those things can be done. If you want to see the 8 parameters simultaneously, 16 parameters simultaneously, 32 parameters simultaneously, similarly you can do a particular parameter can be selected on here by pressing F6 key, right? Now I'll go to the efficiency. So if according to the when we set the calculation on this page, on the calculation page, then on the measurement screen it will show me the energy, efficiency and the losses according to that calculation, whether I'm calculating the motor efficiency between the electrical to motor, or between phase to phase, in between electrical to electrical, single phase to three phase, or three phase to single phase, can be seen on this page. Okay, then even we can plot the XY graphs here. We can select the particular parameters from here. Like this, we can select a particular parameter, and between two parameters we can plot the XY graph as well. On the last page, this is for the motor parameters. So when we connect the ABC channel, we can see the parameters here, like the voltage, RPM, torque and the slip and all those things can be seen here. So this is for the measurement. Now the last one is the file. So in this, when I am having a pen drive or a CF card installed, can be seen here. We can rename the folders, we can delete the folder, we can format a CF card or pen drive, and then next we can create the folders and so on. So if I am having CF card as well as the USB drive, I can copy from here to there also by these kind of selections. Okay, now I'll make the connection for you guys, and I will make the connections by using the voltage probe and current probes. So Hyoki is having very fantastic probes with them, which are having a wide variety range from current and frequency, and the very fantastic thing is that their accuracy. So accuracy can be 0.02%, and now I will try to make the connections. And before that, this is a kind of CTs which Hyoki is producing, and as I told you that they are of very high accuracy and all. So these kind of CTs are there, which is having a lock function here, and they get closed and then they get locked. So these kind of CTs Hyoki is producing, okay, different frequency and different current ranges are there. So I'm going to use this CT to make the connections. So the process is same. I'll make the connections of the current sensor, like RYB. What we have done for power quality analyzer, so similar kind of things we are going to do. I have different CTs with me. As you can see, whenever you would make this kind of connection, the system will automatically detect the sensors. Now we will connect the voltage probes. The neutral R Y B and the neutral I will connect. And similarly, we can do on this demo jig. Right, we have made the connections. Now we will focus towards the power analyzer. Now I have made the connections, everything. Now it is saying that the sensors was changed. And so now the instrument is asking to press the escape. Yeah, the things are there. Now I will switch on the demo jig. Now the demo jig is working simultaneously as the things and the CTs are being connected. Now you can see the things are running, and let me focus more towards the screen. Sorry, I am alone making the video, so I need to focus and refocus again. So now you can see the readings are coming up, and the voltages, current and the power parameters are coming up here. So if I change the voltage and current, the readings will get changed. Can create a three phase, or we can leave it on a single phase, we can do that. And on the system setting, we need to set the voltage and current level for all the channels. So we will do that again. I'll make it to auto, that's better. And for current also, it's better to be on auto. It will automatically sense the ranges and all. And all the things are in RMS. I do not want to make the CTVT ratios and low pass filter, as I want to see the noise and all. So now the ranges and all the things are being set. If you want to see the lowest frequency, we can change it to 0.5 hertz. From 0.5 hertz to 200 kilohertz, we can do the testing. Then the calculation, like okay, the calculation can be done between the phases. So I'll select the first one is pin one is P1, and the P out can be P2, between P1 and P2, means like phase 1 and phase 2, then phase 2 to phase 3, and so on between phase 1 and phase 4. Like that we can do the calculation, and the PM is the motor. I'll make the connections on later on, then I'll explain the motor parameters. Then the time we can select, I'll reduce down to minimum 50 milliseconds, and the timer I do not want, I'll do it myself. The interface, it's a master unit, the data will be saved to CF card, then the autosave function is on. When I start the recording, it will automatically save the data. As I have already selected some of the parameters on this, so the parameters will come, interval we have already set. Right now I'm not doing any kind of configuration with the system, so it's a very simple thing. You need to select the RS-232 or any one baud rate or IP address can be configured. Then the system setting, I do not want to change, everything is fine here. Now the motor, so I'll make the motor connection here. So very simple, the BNC cables are required. So these are the BNC cables which can be used to make the connection between the motor interface, right? So the motor interface I will be shown on the back side. Now I'll make the connections. So if you guys are having a motor which is having a transducer, that can be connected and then we can interface the same. So now I'll do the connection here. The first one, our sensor is giving the torque. Then the second one is giving us RPM. Then the phase. Like that, the parameters I can get. And then I'll feed in this transducer voltage output to my system by the help of these BNC cables. Okay, now we need to do the setting. So the first setting we need to do is the motor sync. Okay, everything is done here. Now we will select the channel A input is the analog, as the motor settings are already been defined here. So I know this motor characteristic, so I'm going to do the same setting here. So the voltage range is 1 volt and scaling is 0.95. And we need to decide the pulses. So how many pulses have been given by this system? This is 360. Okay, now everything is set for the motor testing. Now the DA is not required because I'm not doing that, and we'll start logging, okay, by pressing the start stop key. Just by pressing this start stop key, we can start the logging. Now on the first one is the vectors. We can see the vectors here, and if I change, right? Then the readings will start coming up. I can switch on and off any channel from here, as you can see, like that. I can switch off any of the phase. So like that, you will be able to see all the parameters. I'll again switch on the channels. Right, the channels are being on now. You can see all the parameters here, the phase differences and all. And even the order wise also, right, this is order number 0. If I toggle by up and down key, now the fundamentals started coming up. All the parameters are coming up here, and the frequency you can see, it's a 83. I can change it like that, right? So it's a 76 hertz right now running up. Like that, you can able to see the vectors, right? Then phase one parameters, power, integration, voltage, current, harmonic graph. In that phase wise, we can see like select, we can select the phases and the level percentage of fundamental and the phase wise. And we can select it. This one can show up to 100 order, and we can see 100. We can select whether we want to calculate up to 50 or 25th order. That can be done. And harmonic list also we can see, right? Now the basic THD is also coming up here. So like that, we can see for each phase and related to voltage, current and power, we can see the harmonics and all. So this is phase wise, 1, 2, 3, 4 we can do. All are same. Then now this is the waveform plus noise. So this is voltage and current waveforms. So you can see if I make the changes, see, you can able to watch the voltage and current waveforms in the system, right? So if you want to zoom, you can zoom the parameters like this, right? You are able to see waveforms, and you can simultaneously zoom in and zoom out between the voltage and current waveforms, and you can switch on or off any phase like this for current and voltage. Now the phase wise, you can see separately the voltage and current, whether they are leading or lagging. If you want to see by the waveform wise, you can see. Now this is interesting, this is related to our noise analysis. We can see FFT, like right as per the current frequency and the selection of bandwidth, it is starting from 0 and can go up to 50 kilohertz. So it can be changed according to your selection of the frequency band and the frequency, your operating frequency. So if you want to see the waveform as well as the noise together, you can see, and the parameters are also coming up as per the frequency domain. So if you want to save, it can be saved. All keys are disabled now, and executing, it will be saved to the CF card. So the media which I have selected, it's a CF card right now. Okay, we'll come to the next. Now as I told you, the parameters, we can see 30 parameters at a time or 4 parameters at a time. I can select or I can change what parameter I want to see. Right, very simple. And this is the efficiency calculation. We can calculate the efficiency between any phase to any phase or the losses. We can plot the XY graph as well. Here you can see the graph is between the phase one current and the phase one power. So if I change, now you can see the XY graph is coming up. Okay, so whenever I change, the XY graph is plotting. So it's very easy. So like this, you will be getting the motor parameters here, So by the measurement, you will be able to see all these pages. Vector, the phase-wise voltage and all the parameters can be seen here, waveform plus noise. Then the selectable parameters you can see, efficiency calculations, XY plot, and motor. So this is being done by measure. System is being used for the system setting. You just need to press the page key and you can do all the settings here. And in the file, you will see, able to see the data which you are getting. So the data has been already saved here. And let us now take out the CF card and we will see the data on my laptop. Now to take out the data, it's very simple. I'll put the pen drive and go to the file. Now here is the data. Copy to USB drive. So if you want to create a folder, you can create. Now the data is being copied to the USB drive. And I will see the data on my laptop. Now I have plugged in the USB drive. Now you can see there is a folder by 3390. So there is a data. It's an Excel data. We can open and can see the data. So it's very simple. Yeah. So all the data came here in the Excel format and can be seen. The thing is, like, the 3390 have a very high capabilities as per the specification. I'll read out once for you. This is a Hiyoki catalog. So this is one of the high quality power analyzer from Hiyoki side. So this is having a four channel for voltage, for current, and you can do the efficiency calculations, you can do the motor analysis. If there is this instrument has been given to many EV car charger manufacturers, where they want to see the inverter efficiencies, and because it's a PWM, so it is having a frequency bandwidth from 0 to 200 kilohertz, if I'm not wrong. Yes, it's DC to 200 kilohertz. All the channels are independent. You can make three phase four wire with the combination of the channels, and the fourth channel will be independent. You can do the three phase in and four single phase out, or single phase in three phase out kind of inverter testings. And the motor mechanical parameters can be fed into this power analyzer in the form of voltage and the pulse by using a transducer or something like that, and then it can do the efficiency calculation for the motor as well. So the specification, it can be used from single phase to three phase. All the channels are isolated. The voltage range is from 0 to 1500 volt. The current depends on the current sensors. The Hiyoki is having very fantastic current range of sensors from DC to high frequency megahertz with a very high accuracy of 0.02%. There are very few manufacturers in the world who manufacture these kind of current sensors. And the accuracy, this basic accuracy this instrument gives, is 0.04% AC as well as for the DC. So this is a very fantastic product. And the update rate, the interval rate you will get in this product is the 50 millisecond. So many of the prestigious customers around the globe, they are using 3390. So I recommend you all to, if you have this kind of application, please give a chance and try to call the Hiyoki team, and they will surely come to your place and do the demonstration of the product, like what I have done. Maybe I have missed something, but the Hiyoki team, they are quite good expert around the globe. They will come and they will show you the instrument physically. So this is an instrument. And one more fantastic thing, the Hiyoki gives 3 years warranty in most of their product, including this power analyzer. So give a chance, try and test your products and feel the product. Best of luck. Stay safe. Thank you.